Whoever you are, wherever you race, hit the track like a champion. The YZ250F and YZ450F Monster Energy Yamaha Racing Editions, only from Yamaha.
Hey everyone, welcome to this week's Yamaha Checking In With. We are with Hunter Lawrence of the Honda HRC team, and I haven't seen you since Southwick, so congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
On your first stateside win.
It's been a while, mate. It's been a while.
How did it feel?
Good. I'm pretty tired right now in this current moment. Got sick last week, so it was tough to race, and at the end of the full weekend in a row, so it was tough, but all good, mate. All good. Can't complain, so.
Yeah. All right, so, you know, sometimes the GP guys come to Southwick, right? And then they get here and they're all, this isn't even sand.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know, you've been on the World Championship circuit. How does Southwick compare to Lama? It's like kiddies play, right?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's still tough because it gets really rough, you know? So I wouldn't say it's like kiddies play or like a kid's track, you know? It's still a man's track. It's just not like Lommel terrain, Lommel sand and bumps, you know, like it's still sand. There's still tracks in Europe that are like Southwick for sure. But it's not the traditional deep sand, the big rollers and stuff. Southwick's more choppy, like kind of like a Hawkstone International. In England, there's a track, Hawkstone International. They do preseason races. Some tracks in Holland get like that black sand that get real choppy and stuff. But there's definitely tracks in Europe like it. But no, it's not Lommel or Lerop, you know, the famous GP sand tracks.
Yeah. Regardless, did your GP experience play a role in your win, do you think? Or is it just a good day for you?
Yeah, I mean, yes and no. Maybe just like, I wouldn't say GP experience, just like I was really patient, you know. I knew I could see the guys in front and like they were sprinting as they, you know, you do in the first laps, and I was pretty happy with where I was at. So I was just kind of staying put and they weren't leaving me. So I'm like, all right, whatever speed they're doing, you know, I know I'm going to be able to pick it up in the last 10 minutes if I need to. So, yeah, I don't know. I mean, for sure there's a little bit of sand riding, you know, efficiency and stuff, but at the same time, I feel like my style is a really efficient style. I don't exert a lot of energy into my riding, so.
Okay, so I know that the smack talk between you and Jet is pretty intense. How fun was it to talk shit all week after Southwick?
You know, I'll be honest, I didn't exactly rub it in all week because he had a really bad week, you know. He lost a lot of points in the championship, and he was really bummed on how his weekend went. So I mean, you know, as much as we talk shit and stuff, it's only when we're, you know, both in good moods, you know, when he's really down, I'm not gonna be the asshole and really try kick him while he's down, and then same vice versa, you know. So I mean, a lot of other people definitely made him aware of what was going on, which I was kind of like, you know, it probably wasn't needed, but screw it, like, he paid for it in full somewhere along the line, so.
Nice. As a whole, you got to be pretty happy with the year.
Yeah. Yeah, no, for sure. I mean, you know, this time last year, we were struggling immensely, and we were really starting to, it's kind of in another month or two last year, like August, September, we really started to look at, hey, you know, blood tests, health, extensive health issues, and really go through it. And obviously went in for the final surgery, and my body to come back from, dude, we're talking 5 major injuries and 4 surgeries within a 10-month period, like a year or so ago. It's a lot on your body, so I'm happy, and it's hard to look back on it, but like it's so much that my body's come back from. And you know, to have a few wins this year and then a bunch of podiums and second in the Supercross series and then sitting third now. Obviously, you always want more, but, you know, at the preseason when I was on the couch, you know, with my shoulder injury, our goal was to get back to 100%, you know, just be 100% fit and healthy, not have any lingering issues with my body physically wise, not any lingering health issues. So we're doing really well, and it's good. We're on track.
Okay, so injuries, surgeries, that all takes a big toll on your body, right?
For sure.
Is it a relief to know that you still have really good hair?
Yeah, it doesn't seem to affect the hair, thankfully, but dude, that thing's like a helmet. I can pull it off and it's just there, you know, wake up
like
in the morning.
It's like muscle memory, right?
It is, it's like muscle memory, so yeah, a little blessed in that that side of things, but no, I don't know. It's good
shit. Okay, so heard some murmurs here and there that you guys are still searching with some testing on the CRF250R. Can you elaborate on that at all, what you're looking for out of the bike?
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah, we're still, you know, still fine tuning and stuff, like just still things, you know, we can always be better. We're always different terrains, different tracks, you know the motorcycle so well, we figure out the patterns on what tracks it works well, what tracks we struggle on. The window of having a bike within good rideability, where we can, anywhere in that window, we can make the difference ourselves with our body and compensation. And then once it's out that window and there's only so much you can compensate for on the bike, when it's outside that window, it's really tough. So we try to improve that and make the window bigger, you know. Some bikes straight out of the manufacturer have a really big window of the bike works good here on all terrain. So building it, making it better, all of our feedback obviously goes into the new 2022 bike that's about to launch here soon. So we're really excited about that because we've had a big influence on it.
Okay, so the media, we're going to Oregon this weekend.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Have you spent time on it?
I have. We've ridden it, me and Jed have ridden it. We got a chance to ride it and it's cool, you know, and I can't wait until we get to factoryize it, you know, like HRC modify it and turn it into a factory works bike, because our bikes are so good already, you know, and whenever we say we're constantly working and trying to search and make the bikes better, it's not that they're bad, because they're amazing, you know, like it's just up against what we're racing, you know, like we're always trying to be better. So we're excited, dude, like we get that new bike in, the launch will happen shortly and it'll be awesome.
Any chance you'll race it this year?
There's a very big chance. Who knows, when we get it, we can start to, you know, throw all our parts and all of our stuff and technology and testing and all that stuff onto it. There's a very good chance. If it's better, I think we would, you know.
Yeah. Cool. Well, hey, Hunter, thanks for the time. Guys, thank you for watching this.
Thank you very much.
This episode of Yamaha Checking In With.